Hello and welcome to The Flying Show. My name is Carlos and today on this glorious day we're at Kyneton Airfield and the reason why we're here is going to be made known by the president of the Kyneton Aero Club, Warren Canning. Warren, welcome to The Flying Show. How are you?
Again. Good, Carlos. Thank you. Very well.
How you been?
Yeah, very well, thank you. Very well.
Oh, that's great, mate. Now, what have we got on today on this... You picked the weather, you made it beautiful for everyone to arrive here today.
Yeah, we jagged a very good day, which has been a bit unusual for our hot dog flying. We've had a few very hot or very gusty days, so this is a perfect flying day.
Yeah.
Basically, the first Saturday of the month, we run a gourmet hot dog flying to raise money for the Royal Melbourne Hospital Neuroscience Foundation.
Oh, right.
And we've had our record to date is a Bonanza that flew down from Cessnock in New South Wales.
Oh, how fantastic.
So two gentlemen that heard about the hot dog flying, heard how good the dogs were, and flew all the way from Cessnock and back. So that was a pretty good effort.
Yeah, that is so good. But I think, I don't think it's so much the hot dogs. It's the event, the charity. I mean, you guys do a great job. I mean, 2 years ago, I interviewed Matt Henderson, and we were doing a charity for the Cancer Council then.
That's right, our biggest morning tea.
Yeah, your biggest morning tea. So you guys are doing a fantastic job, and it's no wonder you've actually won an award last year.
That's right. We were the National Aero Club of the Year in 2017, awarded by the Royal Aeronautical Society and Australian Flying Magazine.
Yeah, and rightly so. I mean, look at the work that you do and the amount of people that rock up to these events. It's a fantastic effort by you guys. Well done. I'm looking forward to the hot dogs. We're standing in front of your gorgeous RV6.
That's right, RV6, yes.
Yeah, and this is one that you haven't built.
No, I didn't build this aircraft. It was built by a gentleman called Ed DeGroote.
Yeah, and I understand you're also building your sixth built at the moment. Is that right?
The sixth in the family. When I was a young boy, my father and I built a Thorpe T-18, which Dad then flew to England and back solo in 1976.
That is brilliant.
Then we built a World War I replica SE-5A, then a Rutan Defiant, which was the first twin engine home built in Australia. In my crazy early 20s, much to my wife's disgust, I built a couple of ultralights, a Mitchell B-10 and a Mitchell P-38.
Unbelievable.
And now I'm building a beautiful Italian design with a friend of mine, Ian Miller. It's a low-wing, tail-wheel, tandem two-seat, all timber. Gorgeous thing. Looks like a little PC-9, but a tail dragon.
Is that right? So are we going to get a chance to come in and have a look at that one? And walk around?
Sure, absolutely.
Oh, I'd love to do that. Something to look forward to. And your dad won some awards, obviously, for his flight to England.
Yeah, he was awarded the Oswald Watt Award in Australia, which is the highest award a civilian aviator can get in this country.
Brilliant.
And in the UK, he was awarded the Frederick Turner Trophy, which is their highest award for a civilian aviator.
That is brilliant. Well done. Now, we're going to wander around and have a look at some of the aircraft. There's a beautiful CT-4 coming in with
Murray Wallace
in it. So, looking forward to a great day of magnificent gourmet hot dogs and giving out a bit of money for a very good cause.
Absolutely.
Warren, thank you so much, and we'll catch up during the day.
Look forward to it. Thank you.
No worries. Thank you.